नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर अजीज मोहम्मद खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक बैच कल्चर एंड द सब्जेक्ट नेम इज मॉडलिंग एंड सिमुलेशन टेक्नोलॉजी इन बायो प्रोसेस एंड द डिसिप्लिन इज फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी। So first, we must know what are bioprocess technology. Bioprocess technology is a process that uses a complete living cells or components to obtain some desired products. Okay, and the technique utilizes the use of fermentation technology. So there are three steps in bioprocess technology. The first one is upstream technology. The second step is fermentation. The third is downstream processing. Upstream, what is upstream technology? Upstream processing. Okay, what is this? Upstream processing is the preparatory step for fermentation. Okay, we prepare for the fermentation in this upstream processing. Okay, we prepare our culture media, we prepare our microorganism, we prepare our, we design our process, we design our tanks. This is the designing step. This is the process in which we design our complete fermentation process. Okay, so this is upstream processing. Next is fermentation process. That is the process in which our product is produced. Fermentation process is the use of microorganism for the production of some desired products, in which we give a product, we give a substrate, we give the microorganism, and in a tank, the product in a tank, the product is produced in this tank. Okay, this is the fermentation process in which we give a substrate and we provide some microorganism, and these microorganisms will utilize this substrate, and after utilization of this substrate, the final product will be produced. And after finishing this fermentation step, when we have our product, we go to the downstream processing. What is the downstream processing? Downstream processing is the processing step in which we prepare for our product. We remove the impurities from our product. This is the purification step in which we prepare, we finish our product into finalized formation and then send it to the market. So this is the downstream processing. And in this, a substrate is used and used by some microorganism. And after using the substrate, the substrate is converted into a product by the process of fermentation. Okay, so we need the time, we need to design all the things in this, so that we can calculate the lag phase, log phase, stationary phase, and death phase of the culture. So what is the fed batch culture? Fed batch culture is the actually the process in which we fed the batch. It is the feeding of the batch. Okay, actually we are feeding the culture or the batch. As you are seeing here, this is the vessel, closed vessel, and in this vessel we are giving some product in this. So, but in the process of batch culture. Only this part was there, only this part. Okay. Only this part was there in the process of batch culture, because batch culture was a closed system in which we did not provide any additional source. And in the batch culture, we are feeding it the some of the substrate, little of the substrate is added into the batch. Okay, this is the fed batch culture. So what is the fed batch culture? This is the extending the batch culture by feeding continuously or periodically with medium with no removal of culture from the vessel. This line indicate that in the fed batch culture we add some amount of substrate to the vessel, but we do not remove any kind of culture from the vessel. Okay, so we are not removing anything here. We are only adding some amount of substrate in to the process, but we are not removing any kind of substrate, any kind of microorganism from the reaction. So here we can understand this process. This is the batch culture process. Okay, in this we added some substrate. We added some substrates such as carbohydrate, sugar, that may be anything, and then we added our microbes. Okay, after the completion of this process, it was giving us a product, the finalized product. Okay, we were adding a amount, all the amount of substrate at a particular time. Okay, such as we were giving 20 kg of substrate to the batch culture. But now in the fed batch culture, what we are doing, we are adding the substrate at regular time. So such as we at the starting we adding only 2 kg. Suppose we are adding 2 kg for 2 days, but it was for the 7 days. Batch culture was given all the substrate at a particular time, all for the 7 days. We added all the substrate at a time. But in the fed batch culture, we are adding the substrate at regular time, but little substrate, not all the substrate. So first we added 2 kg, okay, and our microbes. After finishing this step for about 1 day, 2 days, we again add 2 kg. Okay, then again we add 2 kg, and again we add 2 kg, 4 kg, 5 kg, whatever we can, and the process can be completed after completion of this process and when we get our product. So what are the difference, why we need the batch culture to be into फैट बेच कल्चर, वाई डू वी नीड द फैट बेच कल्चर? द रीजन इज दैट इन द बैच कल्चर वी गिव ऑल द सबसेट एट अ पर्टिकुलर टाइम फॉर इट मीन्स फॉर अप्रोक्स ऑल द प्रोसेस नो दैट इज क्लोज एंड वी एडिट ऑल द सबसेट फॉर अब for a particular time, but in the fed batch culture we are giving it at a regular time. So the idea is product which we are getting from this fed batch culture may be number may be high, okay. The product can be high. The second one is that some of the microorganism, when we are adding all the substrate at the particular time, the substrate may be toxic for the microorganism. If we are giving all the substrate at a particular time in the batch culture, the product and the substrate may be toxic to the microorganism. So we cannot add all the substrate at a particular time. Similarly, the another thing is that when we are giving 2 kg, 4 kg, 6 kg at a particular time, or at a regular time, at a time interval, then we are increasing the life of microorganism. Okay, we are increasing the life of microorganism. And when we are increasing the life of a microorganism, the microorganism can produce more and more products. Okay. And the another thing is that these microorganisms are producing the product without any toxic effect. The product does not have any toxic effect, and the product does not need any further downstream processing if we are giving the fed batch process. One more thing can be said that suppose we are giving glucose and as a substrate, and we are giving microorganism for the fermentation in the batch culture, then the produced alcohol may be harmful for the microorganism. Okay, the produced alcohol may be harmful for the microorganism. So we have an idea to increase the amount of substrate at a regular time so that this alcohol cannot be harmful for our microorganism. So this is the idea, this is the advantage of fed batch culture. So this is the comparison of the fed batch culture. In this we added all the biomass, okay, we added, this is the line of biomass, okay, this is the line of biomass, we added all the substrate at the time, okay. And we are similarly, we are getting all the products at a particular time, but in the fed batch culture we are adding the substrate in this way again and again. So there are some difference. What is the difference? Here the microbes are getting harvest, okay, they are getting harvest, but here these microbes are increasing in the number, and the product concentration is also increasing here. As we can identify here, the product number is also increasing. In the batch culture, the amount of biomass is decreased, and the product concentration is also decreased. But in this way, the age of the biomass and the age of the product and age of the microorganism is increased than batch culture. So what are the characteristics of fed batch cultures? It is the medium between the batch culture and the continuous culture. Continuous culture we are going to discuss in our next topic, next lecture. In this fed batch culture, the volume of medium is inoculated with the organism and allowed to grow for a batch period of time. And feed is initiated into the ferment when a carcinogen is obtained. So what is the carcinogen? Carcinogen was obtained from the growth limiting substrate is depleted. What is carcinogen? What is this? It is a state when the substrate concentration is depleted. So we do not want to make any condition when our substrate condition can be depleted. So we invented a new process, that is fed batch culture, so that this carcinogen cannot reach for our our substrate. So what do we do in the fed batch culture? In this fed batch culture, the initial medium concentration is relatively low. The first thing is here, we add the substrate in low quantity in the starting stage. Okay. Due to this condition, there will be a culture growth of microorganism and no inhibition will be occur in this stage. So when this media is depleted, we add some more substrate at regular time. Medium constituents are added continuously or increments. We can also add some constituents of the media such as carbon source and nitrogen source. Okay, what are the carbon sources? We can add some substrates such as apples and grapes. And what are the protein source? These are the carbon source and nitrogen source. And sugar source we can also add, so that the concentration of the substrate can be maintained at a particular time at the time intervals. So this control feed results in the higher biomass products yield, and fermentation is still limited by accumulation of toxic end products. So in this line we can say that in the batch culture fermentation is limited by the toxic products. Okay, but in the batch fed batch culture we have some idea that when will be the toxic products will occur. So we add some more substrates so that these toxic end products cannot come in our product. So there are two types of fed batch culture. The first is fixed volume fed batch culture, and the second is variable number of fed batch culture. So this is the fixed volume fed batch culture. In this, type of fed batch culture, we add the substrate in fixed volume. Okay, we add the substrate in fixed volume. So what is the idea in this? If we add the substrate in fixed volume, the total volume of the culture is not changed. This is the idea. Okay, that we are providing the substrate in limited amount and in fixed volume, so that the total volume of the culture cannot be changed and the culture volume can be maintained practically. Okay, feeding the growth limiting substrate in undiluted form. And the feed is provided at constant rate. In fixed volume batch culture, the production of biomass per substrate is constant during the fermentation time. So this is the in this fixed volume fermentation, the substrate is constant and the production of biomass is also fixed and it is constant, and it depend directly dependent on the concentration of the substrate that we are giving in constant form. So this is the graph in which the biomass concentration is higher here. In this we are giving the biomass, in this we are giving the substrate concentration in at regular time. Okay, but at a regular time the product concentration can be decreased and the product may be lower in concentration because it is directly dependent on my substrate concentration. And this is the growth rate of microorganism can also be decreased. So next is variable mode fed batch culture. In the fixed mode batch culture, we were adding the substrate in fixed volume, but in the variable mode, we are adding the substrate in different volumes, in the increasing volumes. Okay, substrate is provided in a way that maximize the substrate growth rate. Okay, we are adding the substrate in a way that increase the growth of microorganism. So we are not giving in the fixed volume. We are adding the microorganism in such a way that the growth of microorganism cannot stop. It will increase. Okay. The substrate is added here for the biomass production. An exponential feed to maintain a constant growth rate in the culture grown. It is used for the exponential growth of microorganism. It is not for the decreasing phase. So what was the difference? In the fixed volume, we were adding the substrate in fixed volume, but in the variable mode, we are designing the method so that the variable volume of substrate can be added to the process. So this is the graph. In this, the biomass production is fixed here. The substrate volume is after completion. The substrate volume can be variable. And after completion of the process, this is the graph which indicates that the substrate concentration is equal to the biomass concentration. So they are completely dependent. If it will deplete, the biomass concentration will also deplete. So we were adding the substrate at regular time and different volumes. There is also another type of fed batch culture, that is cyclic fed batch culture. In this cyclic batch culture, this is the some updated form of batch culture. In the cyclic variable fed batch culture can be extended by removing portion of culture broth from the vessel. It is similar to the continuous culture. In the cyclic fed batch culture, we are removing some portion of culture broth. Okay. And the remaining culture will become the starting point. If we are taking the some microorganism, suppose that there are 40 ml of microorganism at this time. and the growth of microorganism is at this time growth of microorganism is 40 ml. ठीक, ओके, देन वी रिमूव सम पार्ट ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. सपोज वी आर रिमूविंग 20 ml. सो इन द साइक्लिक वेस्ट प्रोसेस वी आर रिमूविंग 20 ml ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो दिस 20 ml विल बी द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट फॉर द प्रोसेस. This will be the starting that we are adding new microorganisms. So these will divide, these 20 ml microorganisms will divide. They will divide and produce their colonies. Okay. And it will increase in their number. Okay. But if we do not remove these 20 ml microorganisms, these microorganisms will go into the death phase. So there is a requirement of removing these microorganisms. So in the cyclic fed veg culture, we are removing some amount of microorganisms so that the growth will be re-established and the quasi state in which the depletion of substrate is not reached. If there are 40 ml microorganisms, they all are using the substrate, but there are only 20 ml of microorganisms. Only 20 ml microorganisms are using the substrate, and they will use the substrate. So we do not need to add some more substrate. We have to need only add some. We have to need to remove some microorganisms so that these remaining microorganisms will divide and produce the substrate. So this is the idea. In this process, this is the diagrammatical presentation of cyclic fed veg culture. So this is the final stage of the product. In the final stage of the fermentation, we remove some part of microorganisms here. This is the final stage. Okay, this is the final stage of fermentation, and in this final stage of fermentation there are lot of microorganisms there. Okay, and substrate is also there. This is the substrate. Okay, this is the substrate, and there are lot of microorganisms there. So if we remove in this state, we removed some microbes. We removed some microbes. So there are only half of the microbes remaining in this tank. Only half will be remain in this tank, and these half will again divide, grow, and produce complete growth as it was in the previous. Okay, it was as in the previous. We add some more media so that these microbes will again divide and make the product. So there will be no harm to the microorganism. Okay, we need more microorganisms. If we do not remove these microorganisms, they will use only this stage. They will use the substrate and will die. Okay, if we are not adding the micro, if we are not removing the microorganisms, they will use the old substrate, and this substrate will go into the toxic form and all the microorganisms will be died. So what we did, we remove some of the culture here. It is half, about half ml. Suppose it was 40 ml and now it is only 20 ml. and then added some of the substrate. We added some of the substrate, and these remaining microorganisms will again divide and will make some more product as it was in the previous tank. That was the first stage, and that it is second and third. So the third is really really equal to the first. So the volume of the third tank is equal to the first volume, in which it was the older one, and in this we removed some culture and microbes, and it is now half. We added some more medium, some more substrate, and the remaining microbes divide and produce the more products. So this is a cyclic process in which it is in the complete cycle. It is in the cycle form. It is in the starting stage. Here, the bacteria, microorganisms are in the starting stage. They will start their growth again. So we are calling it a cyclic head batch culture. So our lecture is over here. But before overing, we are going to give some advantage of the fed batch culture. What are the advantages of fed batch culture? Low limiting substrate is maintained here. The product phase will be extended in the fed batch culture. For example, in the kojic acid for production and in the enzyme production, the low limiting substrate is maintained. If we are limiting the low level of substrate, it is the example of enzyme production. If we are using the cyclic fed batch culture, it is the example of kojic acid production. And for non-growth associate process, in this system, product fermentation deplete on the specific growth rate of microorganism, and nutrient are fed exponentially to obtain optimum desired product by controlling the specific growth of microorganism. And this is the example of antibiotic production. For the high viscosity growth of microorganism, we can take the example of biopolymer. The next example advantage is they are used for the production of high viscosity products, and the example is biopolymer production. And the high viscosity is reduced. Okay, we do not need any higher viscosity. So fed batch culture reduce the viscosity of the substrate so that the microorganism cannot be harmed by the toxic effect of the substrate. So this is the example of biopolymer production. So we can also use the fed batch culture for the extracellular enzyme production. These are the applications of the fed batch culture. That is the advantage of fed batch culture that you can also read as given in the slides. So our lecture is complete here. We will meet in another video tutorial.